What's going on, guys? Ted from Nerd Immersion here. As you can kind of see here, I'm gonna have to clear off my whole desk because I have what I'm gonna consider one of the mothers of all box unboxings. You see that? This is the D&D Wizkids Icons of the Realms Falling Star Sailing Ship, and we're gonna be doing a full unboxing of this badass full-size sailing ship. I mean, there's just like this is the box. This thing is basically the whole size of this. So if you want to see what's inside and how this looks compared to other size minis, stay tuned. All right, so this is gonna be a little tricky, guys, because this box, as you can see, is clearly huge. My desk only has so much room. And I wanted to use the highest quality cameras that I have to provide you the best picture quality on all of these. So we're going to be going to both this camera that's on me now and then also my SLR camera. However, same as last time, as I just haven't found the time and money to incorporate to do research to find a clean audio or a clean video in for a Elgato Cam Link. And then also the 500 to multiple thousands of dollars to spend on buying a camera just for that. We're getting there, just not there right now. So we're gonna see. So I've got it, excuse me, actually set up off to the side here. So we're gonna kind of get like an over-the-shoulder look down as we actually take it out of the box, and then we'll bring probably cut the video and bring the camera in a little bit closer so you guys can actually see me look at the pieces. So let's see how that looks. All right, so you guys have me kind of in two places. So this is the box. This came in a larger shipping box that also said it was a fallen star ship. This is the internal one, and you can see here it says product has a release date. We're already past the release date, so we're good there. So when we open it up, I can fold down this cardboard here. You can see how just massive this is. And I have some other minis off to the side over here that we will use to kind of show you guys the size of this thing. All right, so in here, it does say some assembly required. So it looks like we've got the masts here. This looks like the sails, I'm guessing, and maybe some more mast material. This is all taped, and my knife is over here. So we can just cut through that. And then this. There's our sails. This is just a piece of cardboard. All right, then we've got plastic in here, looks like. Sorry guys, just take this off. There's little nubs here. I don't think you can see them that are kind of buttons that are holding it together. Sorry, I know this is tragic for the mic here, but oh wait, there's a little tiny piece here. This is the little steering wheel. There is a little bit more tape. Okay, so now we've got our main piece of plastic out of the way. And we can see we've got a little card here that's actually attached to the ship. It says, "The Falling Star, talk to your retailer for details." And here you can kind of, I hopefully see almost all of the ship. Actually, my camera is blocking some of that, so let's put me up top here. All right. So now we're going to extricate. Oh, guys, look at this thing. It's huge. This thing is amazing. All right, so there's the ship. And there's still some stuff inside here. Okay. So inside there is what looks like another deck, basically. We're gonna put that down. Let's see. It looks like there's just cardboard. Yeah, just cardboard and some more plastic. All right. So let us get this out of the way. And let us take a look. See if we can't get this get a little lower and not fall over here. I think that'll work. Well, we're going to try to get this thing in focus to some degree. We'll probably do some close-ups. So as you can see, here is the ship as it stands. We're going to cut off our little tag here. So we've got... Oh, boy. All right. So if we look at the side, we've got cannon ports all along the side here. What is this? 6 cannon ports. Got a little ladder to climb up onto the boat. The front has some really nice detail. We can get in up close here. It's a dragon. I don't think you can make that out. Oops. See? Okay. Apparently that pops up. We'll come back to that. So it's a dragon up here in the front. We've got a nice little claw kind of anchor here on the one side, but our masthead is silver dragon, maybe? Kind of hard to tell. It's got some frills on the head here. And again, I will bring this in for closer looks, but I wanted to get the whole thing in frame. So it looks like, again, I just pushed up underneath here. Oops. And you can see that the whole ship pops up like that. If you wanted to... Oh, okay, look, and it's magnetic. Oh, that's how the masts attach. Okay. So, well, now we took the whole thing apart so we can get an idea. So you can do that, and it is just the base, the solid plastic shell base here. And these are identical on the top and the bottom. So this just sort of sits in here. So if you want to take your, and I guess we can look at the deck here, right? So it's got a little door that opens here, and a little portholes on either side, and the two sets of stairs. And this looks like it. There is actually 2 notches here and a cutout in the deck here. So we can just kind of slot. Oh, and these actually little pieces grab onto the deck, or the railing rather. So we can go ahead and just snap that right back in. So now if you wanted to say, you can take these pieces here. They just sort of sit in here like this. Nice and easy. There you go. And that popped up a little bit. So we can just drop that in. And that should sit, I think, perfectly. Just want to make sure it's a little wobbly, but that may have been when I took everything apart. Oh, you know what? We're not snapped in completely. Actually, you know what? It does act, just as a heads up to you guys, this does have a slight curve to it, so it does look like it kind of comes on a downward angle here rather than sitting completely flush, which seems a little strange to me because you can kind of, I think you can make this out. This is angled, like it's gonna, your minis aren't gonna sit flush on this. Again, maybe that was me, but this is all pushed in accordingly, unless I'm, no, I think you can see this. There is very clearly a downward slope in here. And I'm basing that off of what I put in up here in the front. This is flat, right? This isn't curved at all. It just kind of dropped in there. So doing the similar fashion over here, you would think it would just do the same, but it is curved downward. Now that may be on purpose, but I just feel like it makes your minis... let's see. I guess it doesn't really matter. I guess I'm just a little over-exaggerating. Another thing I will say is it doesn't seem to include any, it doesn't seem to include any, like, instructions. Not that you really need it, right? The ship kind of makes sense as to what it is, but it doesn't tell you anything, so you kind of have to figure that out on your own. So, one thing I did notice, just playing around with this a little bit, was when I flipped this thing over, this side is gridded. This side is not, this side is. So if you did want to use this for tactical combat, you could flip it to the grid side. I'm going to go out on a limb and assume that the front is also gridded. But let's just check. Yep, also grids on the front. So let's take our masts out here. So these do feel like they have a mat. Yep. Bring my hand out of the way. So... our masts do stick in with magnets. So that's good. It'll help keep them in place when you are using it to traverse your terrain. Okay, there are 2 masts. Now, let's see what we've got in this other bag. Oh, here we have our little, our steering wheel here. So these don't have magnets, and this doesn't have any specific placement, so it seems, but, you know, I feel like it should be sort of over here-ish, right? Like in the back. And I, again, I'll have to zoom in, but the detail on these minis, like, you probably can't see it right now. Maybe I can zoom it in. Let's see if you guys can get a good look at it. The, like, the rigging, like, it's, like, individual little ropes. Like, this steering wheel? I don't know if you can make that out, but, like, there's, again, I'll come in closer, but there are tiny little, like, ropes on all of this, and it looks really good. And I know I've said a couple things in the past, you know, in the other videos where it looks like the paint jobs on some WizKids minis are less than stellar. And that, like, there's splotches of paint and things. This one, from my glance, it looks like it is spot on. Like, there is no, like, drips of any other kinds of paint. It looks like, I mean, and rightfully so, right? This is a $250 mini. So I just cut open. Yep, there goes those silicone beads everywhere. Nope, I'm gonna have to vacuum that up after this. Alright, let's get the sails out of here. So, we've got one little piece in here as well. My arm is full of silicone. Yeah, we're definitely gonna have to vacuum that up later. Alright, so these are held together with little ropes. And, how do we do this? Let's take a look at the box and see how it's done. Oh, I think this, yep, this is for right here. That's for the extend the mast ahead of the ship. All right. These are supposed to both face forward, like so. Then we're going to attach the two smaller ones, it looks like, to these nubs here on the front. And it looks like they do have keyways, so it should be easy to figure out. So I think this goes, let's see, like this. Yep, that snaps in right there. And this one, they all are unique keyways too, it looks like. So that's a nice, that's nice. And what about this one? One, I think, goes a little sideways like this. I think. Yep. Okay. This guy here like this. Okay, and this one over here, like this. So if you look at the box, it looks like it kind of has it going sort of like that. So here is now with all of our sails. Now, I don't know, it looks like these are all tied up currently with little actual twine string, not just like fake plastic. So if you really desperately wanted to, it looks like you could cut or untie those to actually drop the sails to have the full sail on the ship. I don't really think it's necessary, but obviously it's your mini, right? Do what you want. I guess there's a couple other details we should talk about. We didn't really look at the back. Oops. So those magnets, not super strong, as you could see. So let's go ahead and turn it around. So in the back here, you can see we've got all the windows for what's probably the captain's quarter. We do have a movable working rudder here. I say working, just movable. We do have portholes here to look in the inside. Same six cannon ports and ladder on the other side as well. Okay, so that is that. Let's put our masts back up. Put our steering wheel here. And here goes our masts. So again, not really designed for being like lifted and moved around too much. You may lose them. And then we also have in here, looks like two other sets of of decking. And these, if I recall, are supposed to be, are these the full length of the boat? These, I think, this is, again, we've got grid on one side and not on the other. I think this is supposed to represent below deck. And I believe, yeah, let's see here. So, this one does, this should be the bottom deck, right? Because there's no ladders or staircases, I guess. And then this one does have a staircase. So my thoughts are these are probably supposed to sit inside the ship, but I believe you're supposed to actually keep them off to the side, so when people are not on the top deck and they want to go below, they can do that. The only, again, the only downside I would say to this is not, like I said, I think I just figured out the whole instructions to do this, but it doesn't specifically state what or how to do that. So if you really wanted someone to tell you what that was for, you might have some issues there. But let's see if we can actually do that. Let's take off our masts again. Set them to the side. And we will take up our push up from the bottom. Pop up our upper deck here. Take out front here. Let's see if that'll work. This is a little tricky, taking out these pieces. Back one's a little easier because of the angle. And then we could lift out this. So, it looks like, actually, you might be able to fit one. It doesn't seem, let's see. Because this is all going to sit right here. So let's see if we can line these two up and see if we can't slot them in somehow. Can we just stick them? No, they won't fit inside the bottom. They're too big to fit in there. And the way this is set up, I don't think you can kind of angle these. No. Okay, so fortunately, that's something I would have liked to have seen, would have been for these extra decking to show you going below deck and further down. I would have liked to have seen a means to store them inside the ship. Even if they wouldn't be functional, just because you need to have these pieces here where the magnets are held to hold the masts on, it would have just been a nice convenience thing to have these sit inside, so that way you didn't have to figure out what you want to do. Because these also don't have the cutouts in them, so you can't use them as the main deck because they don't have the cutouts to put the ladder pieces in. So I guess what it's supposed to be is this is your top deck that sits in here like this. Right, and it makes sense that this is the top deck because it's got the cutouts for the other pieces, and it also has kind of the grates and the kind of ports where the masts attach, as well as the stairs going below. Then I'm guessing this should be the next deck down because you've got two more sets of stairs and the mast, and then down here you kind of got the base of the mast attachments and no stairs, is my assumption. But I could be wrong. Those of you who are sailors or have better knowledge of historical vessels and sailing ships than I, feel free to correct me in the comments down below. So I'm going to reattach this, and then we're going to take some minis and stick them on here just to show you kind of the scope and size of this thing. And I've got minis of basically every size that I have access to, which is most of them. So we should get a pretty good idea. Get an idea of how easy this is to snap back in too. Okay. Go. We are back in there, I believe. Yep. In there. Yes. Okay, that snapped back in. That snapped back in. Put in. I really pissed about the freaking silicone beads that I dropped everywhere. What an idiot. All right, So that's then, that's in. Masts are going back in. And steering wheel. Okay. So, that's all taken care of. What are these little plastic pieces inside here? Three little tiny plastic nubs. They don't look like they were important, I hope. All right, so we've got the ship here, and then again for some scaling, here is a medium-sized mini on the deck of the ship. So this would be your characters more often than not sailing the ship up on the front deck, whatever the case may be. We have a large-sized mini, so this is a Wizkids Pit Fiend. Give you a little bit of a size reference here. Pit Fiend, up here next to our medium character, give you an idea of the scope. Here is a huge size mini. So this is the Wizkids Garistro. Put him on the deck, you can get an idea how big he is compared to the size of this thing. Sorry folks, the camera died. Then here is a Wizkids Gargantuan mini, I think is the next size up. So this is Niv-Mizzet, the Guildmaster of the Izzet League from Guildmaster's Guide to Ravnica. I'm gonna move the mast out of the way here just so you can get a little bit of an idea of the size here. So I'm gonna lay the mast down here. So we've got medium, here's a large mini, here's a huge mini, here's a gargantuan mini, and then I have over here the gargantuan black dragon from the old Wizards of the Coast set. Obviously they were slightly larger than the new ones. To give you an idea here, we can move Niv-Mizzet here to the back, put the dragon here on the front. But what's most important is this ship is large enough that all but probably the colossal red dragon mini can land on this ship, and you could have a fight with a dragon on the deck of the boat. So this is just freaking awesome. This is a huge mini set. It's almost like it's a mini slash terrain piece, honestly. I think it's really well made. Like I said, the sculpt and the paint job on it seems to be really well. I will cut it and come in close so you guys can get a good look at some of the really unique pieces. But overall, I'm really, really pleased with this. I do also want to say a huge shout out to Jessa and Chris and the whole WizKids team for providing me this mini to do a review on for you guys, to give you an idea of what you're getting yourself into if you decide to spend the $250 and jump in on this mini. So I think it's really cool. It's very topical with the Ghosts of Saltmarsh campaign coming out shortly, which is a whole nautical themed campaign. So having a boat for nautical themes makes a lot of sense, and I'm sure that wasn't by accident. Yeah, so let me know what you guys think in the comments about this mini. I think it's pretty great. I'm not sure. I'm not really confident on the pricing, right? I don't really know what this is, you know, what a mini of this size is worth. Based on what these guys went for back in the day and what they're still going for now, I don't think $250 is out of the realm of reality. It seems like it's a pretty good idea. Based on the size and what you all get. Like I said, my only pet peeve on this whole thing is I'd like the magnets to be slightly stronger, and I wish there was a storage inside the mini for these two extra deck pieces, just so that if you need to take it somewhere, you can take the whole thing with you, not have to like take it and then also these separately. But yeah, we can clip in our masts here. So yeah, you could absolutely have a dragon attack your boat. The only other potential downside I see is the size of this boat is a pretty massive, expensive boat in the terms of Dungeons & Dragons gold. So it's probably not something your PCs are going to own, unless that's a function of the new Ghosts of Saltmarsh campaign. But definitely something they could possibly rent or seek passage on. And then you guys get to make a whole, or buy a whole bunch of, or whatever you need to do to get a whole bunch of cool pirate minis to have a really cool pirate ship. So yeah, that's my thoughts. I'm gonna cut the video here and jump in close to show you off some of the more details with the closer cam, and then I will close out this review. All right, so here we are with a little more zoomed in version of the ship. You can see the dragon, that's the masthead here again with the frills. Like I said, I'm thinking maybe silver dragon or just generic dragon, but it's D&D, so probably something. Here's the sort of dragon claw anchor. This does not come out. It is limited to this little chain link right here. But here you can see the little portholes that do actually look into underneath the deck here. Spin it over this way. Move our camera a little bit. Zoom it in. You can see the cannon ports I was talking about. They do flip all the way up. There are no cannons, and there's probably no real way to actually put them in there, just based on the way we looked at the underside of the ship. But there's that. Here's our little ladder. I guess I could take off the mast and actually show you now. If we can get this to focus. There we go. You can see the detail on all the little. So this is all plastic, these ropes. But here up on the mast, this is actual like twine. And it looks like it is basically just a loop. So like I said, I think based on what I'm seeing here, you can unfurl these if you want. But you'll have to unhook something somewhere. And you've got your little platforms up here, and then your upper sail. And then again, there's the magnet's actually hidden in the bottom that just snaps into the base. We'll spin our ship all the way around so we can show you the back of the ship here. So here you can see the little windows. You can see our nice gilded rudder here. Well, I forgot to stop the recording, but at least this time we were prepared for dead batteries with spare batteries on deck. I guess we can get a little bit closer, zoomed in look at the steering wheel. So here you can see it's got all this little like filigree pieces. And like, look at these little like ropes. These are plastic, but still, look at that detail. And like the perfect paint job. No splotches, the wood looks weathered, the ropes look real. I'm thoroughly impressed with the quality of this mini. And again, like I said before, probably should be given the fact of what you're spending on it. So let's go ahead and pop off the ladder piece here. We may lose our dragon. Actually, yeah, we're gonna take the dragon down here. We'll pop off this, because this is the other kind of major piece to look at, is our dual sets of ladders. So you can see, again, a very, zoom that in a little bit, get more in focus. You can see it's very finely detailed, down to like the wood grain on this. And you can see in the middle here, we've got our closing door with our embellishments on it, and our little portholes as well. I mean, all in all, like, look at the quality of this. I mean, it is a pre-painted mini, right? So sometimes that's hit or miss, right? And here's our base here. And I will actually say, I did notice this now. Remember I said before, like, what are those little nubs? Those are actually these sort of these stick-ups that are right here. You can see how I have a couple, but then I don't have some. Those are very brittle. You can see this one's actually kind of bent. Those broke off in shipping. So I would just be mindful of that. If you hang on to them with a little bit of probably super glue or something, you could probably tack those right back on. Mine are gone because I threw that out. But that's okay because it just makes the ship more rustic. And like that was part of it. See, so this one doesn't have that. That different setup for the rigging here. But yeah, I think... I don't think I really need to go into the specifics of the decking and the bases, but I'll show you guys a little bit here. So you can see that this is the non-gridded side that I was talking about. This is the back of the ship. And then you can see here, it just has grids on it. And then we can take a look here at just the sub-deck. Right, so we've got our masts coming down, and then our staircase going below, and then on this side it's just the same thing but gridded. And then on the very, what I'm assuming is the very bottom, right, I'm assuming that's why we have the dark on the sides, is to represent kind of like the bowing of the ship. We don't have any staircases, and we have these kind of blocks around the masts, and then again on this side it's just the gridded version. So yeah, I wanted to give you guys a little more of a close-up view. And I guess I can sort of do this too if we move our dragon out of the way. And move the ship. and kind of do a quick lift with the camera, you can see the slot there. That is where this slot right here on the bottom of the ladder, that slips into this slot, and these little hooks on the top of the ladder clip onto right here, and the side of it slides into the little slots that you can see right there. So, and then again, just to show you the ease of putting this back in, you'll just take this, put it the right way, push it down, the middle piece slots in, like that, snaps in, that's done, and then we can just take our back piece and just drop it in. And now we have the back of the ship all ready to go. Put our dragon as the captain here. Zoom it back out and give you guys one more quick look at everything. Put this a little bit more in focus. But yeah, I mean, look at this. Like I said, look at the size of this ship. So like, you could be a little guy hanging out up here. But like, you could fit massive amounts of enemies on this ship, or massive amounts of players. Very cool. Yeah, I like I said, I am astounded at this mini. I would love to see more minis like this in the future. So anyway, guys, that was it for my review of the Falling Star ship here from Wizkids. Ignore the vacuum again. I did, in between cuts, vacuum up all of the silicone beads that I spilled literally everywhere. But yeah, I'm really, really excited, and I'm, again, once again, super grateful to the folks at Wizkids for sending me this for review purposes. We're getting to a part in my homebrew campaign where one of the groups has a boat, and another group may be looking to commandeer or purchase or, you know, pay for passage on one. So this will most likely be getting used. The only downside that I see, like I said, is the lack of storage for these pieces, right? You don't have a good place to stick these inside to store them. So you just kind of have to carry them separate. And like, now I kind of want another one so I can have ship to ship combat. But I guess that'll probably have to wait. So like I said, thank you again to WizKids. Sorry about the green square, the red square in the middle. I'm working to get a better camera so we don't have to deal with that. But let me know what you guys think of the quality of the video. I did my best to try to keep things in focus and adjust the aperture settings on the camera to kind of give us more breadth of focus so we're not so honed in. But I would love to know what you guys have to think about this, whether you'll be picking one up yourself or if you already have one. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it. Have you used it? Do you have plans for it? Let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see you guys next time.